Now, again it, didn't it? Done it again, Inter. Started a bloody review we now. Now, we were at work the other day, and we were talking about food, and there was an advert in the paper for these Richmond sausages, right? It's 12 thick pork sausages. Now, apparently these are the number one selling sausage in the UK. The bloke who did it, he got the recipe in 1907 or something. Set up a shop in Scarborough or somewhere up north. And these have been going. Hold on, there's some writing on the back. Let's have a look. I've got my glasses now. So, it's fair to say we know a thing or two about sausages. Well, I'll be the judge of that. This is my review, and I've had a lot of sausages in my time. And we've been proudly making them for over 100 years. That's 100 years. That's a long time. By staying true to our own secret Irish recipe, we create this delicious taste everyone loves. Everyone loves. Now, I can remember having these when I was a kid. So you're talking around, oh God, probably 40 years ago. And I honestly can't really remember the taste. So in theory, this is a completely new thing to me. How to cook? You cook them for 20 to 25 minutes on gas mark 5, or you grill them for 20. Our own special Irish recipe is made with the subtle flavors of nutmeg and pepper. But the secret of our success is a dash of family spirit. What the bloody hell's family spirit? Get in there, Johnny, and cook them and make them bloody sausages. That's not family spirit. Right. Now then, this is the important bit, right? Now, these are 12 thick pork sausages. 12 pork sausages. So you read the ingredients. Pork, 42%. 42%. Now, I'm no mathematician. I'm no Carol Vorderman. I might have a fat bum, but I'm no Carol Vorderman. That's a bit of an insult to Carol Vorderman, because she's got quite a good bum extra, really. Anyway, that's by the by. 42.5% pork. If that was a pork sausage, that'd be like nearly 100% with a few bits and bobs, flavouring and stuff. It's got water. Water. Pork fat. Rusk. Rusk. What do you want to eat rusk for? Wheat. Soya protein and a load of other stuff, colouring in, plant extracts that helps keep our sausages succulent. Don't know. Proudly produced in the UK with meat from Great Britain and the EU. So that could be anything really, couldn't it? From the EU. EU. Hey you, how about just making them out of British pork? But as it stands, like I say, my wife works at a meat wholesaler's in town, and we buy all our meat. Well, I'd say 95% of our meat comes from there. Sometimes I might fancy a bacon sandwich, and we've got no bacon, so I bop up Costy Cutters and I get them there. And I thought I would try some Richmond sausages and to see if they are the UK's number one. This bloody camera thing, I've got to get a better grip, better camera, tablet holder. So, me sausages have been in, and I thought I would show you pretty much everything that comes. That is from four sausages. That amount of fat or water or whatever it is. That's just grease, right? That would taste horrible. So, don't get me wrong, right? I know when you're cooking something with pork, you're going to get seepage of fat. Because let's face it, a pig is fat and that's it. That's the flavour in it. But that's a lot. I mean, the sausages we have from our missus's place, you don't get hardly any. You know what I mean? We don't get hardly had any. So people, you know, when you go shopping for products, meat products, just take a step back and go and visit your local butchers, because it's proper meat, right? So here we go. This is a Richmond sausage. I've done two, and there's two over there for the kid. You thought I was going to say the dogs, didn't you? But no, for the kid. For the kid upstairs. The school holidays are nearly over, and the kid will be back at bloody school soon. Right, so I've had these in for 25 minutes. These have got skin. Right. That's how the sausage looks in there. It does have a rusky kind of smell. Rusk, not rust, rusk. Like a homemade kind of wheaty smell. No, that is wrong. Put my glasses on. Let's read these bloody ingredients again. Salt, flavourings and stuff like that. What it's... Why did I read it? This is of nutmeg and pepper. You certainly get an overwhelming taste of nutmeg. And you do get a strong taste of pepper. So I think what this is... There's the sausage again, folks. It don't look that appetising, does it, really? And I mean, I don't know. Perhaps people love these things. Perhaps people love them. But it's just mass-produced mush. I can't see how that's the UK's favourite sausage. Do people, I tell you what it might be the UK's cheapest sausage, and people go in and think a sausage is all the same, a sausage is all taste the same. Well, no, folks, sausages do not all taste the same. You have got different flavoured sausages. You want your Lincolnshire ones, yeah? You can get some with red Leicester in. And all that, you've got to try the breakfast sausage, folks. All brilliant sausages. This is just, I don't know. Don't get me wrong, folks, right? If you've come home from the pub and you've had a few and you just want a sausage sandwich, you can whack these in and you won't know any different. But if you actually want to try a sausage that's, No. There's no... You can't actually taste any sausage. You can't taste any meat, pork product. All you can taste is the nutmeg, the pepper, and the rusk. That's what it is. And then just as it's going down, you get a bit of pork. And honestly, folks, please... I'm not saying don't ever buy Richmond sausages again, right? But if you go into a shop and you're looking for sausage and mash tonight with mushy peas with an onion gravy, right? Don't just go and try something a little bit off the kilter for you and get a proper sausage. Or get down your local butchers, get down your local meat wholesalers and try something different. Try something new. Try and expand that mind and try something that's not been mass produced mush. People will buy these. You know, Richmond will still keep going. And I will eat the other eight or whatever, or the kid will eat the other eight, or we'll have them in some kind of stew that beefs them up a bit. But no. Anyway, these have cooled down, right? They're not hot. I left them sitting so I could actually eat the damn things and not burn my mouth out when I bit it. So, this is the all-important test. Ah! Dog swallowed it. Doodle. So there you have it, folks. I've tried Richmond sausages. They're supposed to be the number one selling sausage in the UK. I don't know. I don't know. People, leave me your comments and what you think of the sausages. And see if you like a 42% pork sausage that's basically got more nutmeg, pepper, and rusk in it than meat. Really, it shouldn't be called a sausage, should it? Should be called something else, like a rusk sausage. I don't know. All right, folks, laters.